We've all seen them before. These cool-looking tiny planet videos have been popping up all over the place. And today, I'll show you how you can add this fun tiny planet effect to your own 360 videos. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge, and welcome back to my channel. To make your own tiny planet video, you need some 360-degree footage recorded with a 360 camera, such as a GoPro Fusion or an Insta 1X, and an editing program capable of editing 360 video. For this example, I'll be using Final Cut Pro 10. If you're not a Final Cut user, you can download a free 30-day trial by clicking on the link in the video description. Let's open up Final Cut Pro and get started. First, import your 360 videos by clicking the Import button in the top right corner and navigating to your videos. Select your video in the media browser and open up the inspector by using the keyboard shortcut Command 4. At the top of the inspector window, select the Info tab and scroll down until you see the 360 projection mode. Open the drop-down menu and select Equirectangular. Repeat this step for every 360 clip you've imported. Next, let's create a new video project by clicking the New Project button in the bottom half of the window. Give your project a name and click the Use Custom Settings button. Set your video format to 1080p HD and select your preferred frame rate. To add your video to your project, select it in the browser and click and drag it down into your project timeline. Because you added a 360 video to a non-360 project, you'll only see a part of your clip in the viewer that looks like it was recorded with a regular camera. This is called the master orientation of your clip, and I explained it in one of my previous videos. If you haven't seen it yet, I'll link it up top and in the video description below. Adding the tiny planet effect to this video is very simple in Final Cut Pro. Make sure your video is selected in the timeline, head over to the inspector, and select the video tab. In the orientation control section, click on the mapping drop-down menu and select Tiny Planet. Your 360 video will be instantly converted to look like a tiny little planet. Next, let's look at some of the adjustments we can make to improve how it looks. You can adjust the size of your tiny planet with a field of view slider. Drag it to the right to make it smaller, or left to make it bigger. You can also rotate your video by adjusting the pan or the y-axis. For the most precise way of adjusting this, click on the number beside it to select it, and use the up and down arrows to rotate your video. You can also select the adjustment dial beside it and click and drag it to rotate. The tilt and roll adjustments can be used to change the point of view by rotating your video on the x-axis or the z-axis. Let's try this on another clip, and this time, animate it to make your video go from a normal field of view to a tiny planet, or the other way around. Select a different video in your media browser, and add it to the end of your timeline by pressing E on your keyboard. Place your playhead a couple seconds from the start of your clip, and select it by clicking on it. Up in the inspector, change the mapping to tiny planet. To make it appear as a regular clip, we first need to change the field of view to 90 degrees. You can use the field of view slider, or you can click on the number to select it and type in 90 on your keyboard. Use the tilt and pan controls to reframe your shot. Once you're happy with the framing, add a keyframe to all these parameters by clicking the small diamonds beside each one. Move your playhead ahead a few seconds and change your tilt parameter back to 0 and field of view to 360. Adjust your field of view to resize your tiny planet, and the pan parameter to rotate it. When you play it back, Final Cut Pro animates your video clip to go from your starting shot to a tiny planet look. You can also adjust the speed of this effect. Right-click on your clip in the timeline and select Show Video Animation. Here, you'll see two keyframe points for the start and the end of your animation. Click and drag these points closer together or further apart to speed up or slow down your animation. Let Final Cut Pro render out your video and you're done. For a cool effect that looks like this. If you want to learn more about 360 video or Final Cut Pro, check out the rest of my channel. New videos upload weekly, so if you enjoyed this one, make sure to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you back here next week.